Today we'll discuss Process FMEA, Risk Management of Process Improvement. Hi, this is Mike Negami, Lean Sigma Black Belt. Today our topic is related to Lean Sigma, which we haven't talked about in a long time. It's about FMEA, failure mode and effect analysis. We conduct FMEA after designing a new product, new service, or new process in a Kaizen project. In the make, it's usually done at an early stage of the improve phase. In order to increase the probability of success with FMEA, we can identify potential problems at the design stage and prevent those problems beforehand. Originally, FMEA was developed by the US Army in the 1950s, and it began to be used in the aerospace industry and manufacturing industry where failures are not allowed. Now it's used in many industries because of Lean Sigma. You can also use it in process improvement projects for service operations. Try using it in projects which are spending a lot of time and cost, or where failures are not allowed. Since we have a template for this, it's not difficult to do. There are few kinds of FMEA used in the manufacturing industry, but today we'll focus on the process FMEA that can be used to improve service operations. This is the process FMEA template, and there are the instructions next to it. The first column is a column for writing the name of each step of the designed process. In the next column, list potential failures that could occur in each step. We call it failure mode. I made a video about human error in the past, since it will be helpful for you to think of what causes potential failures. Please watch the video by clicking the link above. Other than human error, write other failure modes related to tools, equipment, or environmental factors. Next, write all impacts when it happened in the next column. With this answer, you can quantify the severity of each failure mode. For normal FMEA, the measurement is 1 to 10, but since this template is a simplified version, please put a number from 1 to 5. 5 is the most severe. Next, you write possible causes that could cause each failure mode. This is for estimating the occurrence in the next column. This will also be quantified from 1 to 5. The highest occurrence is 5. Next, consider whether there is current preventive measures, and if so, write the preventive measures. By referring to this, you can quantify detection, which is how difficult you can detect each occurrence from 1 to 5. The most difficult to detect is 5. You enter the severity, occurrence, detection. The value multiplied by the 3 will appear in the RPN column, which stands for risk priority number. The higher the RPN, the higher the priority. If there are many failure modes, it's more efficient to deal with those that are higher priority. Therefore, after listing all failure modes, sort the whole table by the RPN column in descending order. Then input recommended measures and deadlines and person in charge from the highest priority failure mode. Have them report each completion and record actions taken and completed date in the next columns. Once you have done up to this point, you have taken many preventive measures, but you only did P and D of the PDCA cycle. In order to ensure all preventive measures are executed, let's also do C, which is the check step. After recording the completion report, re-evaluate severity, occurrence, detection, and look at the risk priority number again. If further actions are needed, write them in the remark column and conduct them. As you can see, you can rotate an effective PDCA cycle on this piece of paper. I also introduced the template for risk management in the past, and this FMEA is similar to it. The previous one is for risk management of project management, and this one is for risk management of a newly designed process. Thank you very much for viewing. Please click the subscribe button. Also, click and watch my other related videos. Thanks.